Shook it up.
Good morning and welcome to a full day of eating. Today is Saturday, it's the 2nd of June, and I'm in a very messy kitchen because this is the reality of it. I've just gotten up, I'm not showered, I just thrown on some clothes, and last night Lex and I had some food, I made some guilt-free cocktails, and now I have to clean up. So we have bins to be taken out, dishes in the sink, lime halves, we have a crazy puppy, we have a light and a tripod because I was recording my chili recipe. So first things first, I'm going to take out all of these bins, tidy up this kitchen, and then we'll get on with our day. Dishwasher is on, everything is nicely cleaned up, yay! I love a clean kitchen. So I'm starting my day with some water and my supplements. Still have my liners in, so I'm lisping a little bit. So what I am taking right now, I always take my zinc. This is really good for repair of, like, cellular repair, recovery. Selenium, again, great for your skin, hair, nails. Excuse me, little lady. Mommy is trying to record something right now. You have to be quiet. And then we've got some DIM. So DIM is diindol methane. Diindolly methane with black pepper extract. I'm taking this because it was recommended from my previous cellulite video, and it's meant to help with the absorption of excess estrogen, which can lead to more prominent cellulite. So I'm just going to be taking this. I've been taking it for about 3 weeks now. We'll see how it goes and see if it actually helps. Every little thing helps, so might as well just take it. It's not doing me any harm. And I've started taking this collagen, which I got on Amazon. I also got this on Amazon. Now the collagen, again, I take 2 tablets of this. It's hydrolyzed collagen. You have natural collagen in your skin, underneath your skin, and as you get older, that reduces down. So if you start taking a supplement of collagen, that can help with the aging process. It can help again with cellulite. So I'm just taking everything that's gonna make me feel better and look better and age better. First things first, take all them with as much water as I can take down, and then we'll get on with the day and my usual decaf coffee, my usual protein little muffin, and maybe I might get dressed. Maybe. And do my hair. This is the chic, slept in look that I'm going for right now. So part of my morning routine is obviously to clean up. I put on the radio. I try not to put on the TV because I can get sucked into watching series on Netflix, and I like to be a bit more productive. So I've been on my social media, replying to all your comments on my previous video, on my fitness journey video. I'm really happy with how it has come across and how it's been perceived by people. It obviously was a very difficult video for me to make, so, and I put it off for so long. So it's really nice to be getting some positive feedback and that I feel like I'm helping people. And just to remind everyone that nobody's life is perfect. We all have our ups and downs, and we just have to kind of go with it as much as we can and just try and fight the downs. I have fed the dogs. I'm going to empty the dishwasher now. I have a very normal domestic life, guys. It's not all glamorous Instagram photos. Right now I'm going to make my decaf coffee, and I'm gonna have one of my carrot cake muffins. Structure and organization for me helps me when I'm feeling down and when I feel like things are kind of getting away from me and I feel out of control. I like to just like control my environment, and that's the first thing. So having things tidy and organized for me is quite important. So that is why cleaning my kitchen, having my little routine in the morning is therapeutic for me. First decaf coffee of the day, and oh, someone seems to have taken a little bite out of that. It may have been me. I'm gonna have my decaf coffee, my muffin, and I'm gonna reply to more of your comments on my latest video and get on with my day. And at some point I will shower, I will do this mop of hair. As you can see, I'm getting used to the bangs now. I did trim them a little bit last night. I don't know how well they'll fare when I wash it. I've taken my braids out. I'm still not showered. Lex is up. And I'm gonna make him a mocha. I might make myself a mocha too. I'm getting a coffee though, I haven't had a coffee yet. That is the plan for now. I'm kind of liking these waves. Maybe I shouldn't wash my hair. Maybe I'll just dry shampoo it. And then put on some makeup, make myself look half decent for the world. It's just to update you guys on my current macros as Roxy makes noise and the kettle boils. That I am currently back up to maintenance macros and my weight has been holding steady at about 117 pounds. I will do a physique update after I get out of the shower. Yeah, so my weight has been holding steady at about 117 pounds all this week. I've been hitting my macros quite consistently. Obviously the last couple of weeks I had been traveling a lot and not able to track my macros properly, not training properly. Now I am back training 5 days per week. Previous to that I'd only been doing 4 days, but now I'm up to 5 because I've added in an extra leg day. I've been trying to do a more dynamic leg day and I'll be due to do that today, so I'll record that workout today just to show you what I mean by dynamic. I feel like I just need to move more in my workout, so it's a lot of body weight and just jumping squats, things like that, just to get the circulation going. I also have been doing sprints about 3 or 4 times per week and I do about 10 to 15 minutes, so it's usually 30 seconds of sprinting and then a minute of walking on the treadmill, and I just feel it's really helping just with my legs. And that is the goal right now, is to improve the tone and make my legs look better and match my upper body, which always looks quite lean and sculpted. Yeah, actually I'm quite liking this hair. So for Alexa's white chocolate mocha, we use about 11 grams of the Options white chocolate, and I use this barista blend oatly milk. Now this is the only one that will really froth for making coffees. Me and Lex really like the taste of this oatly milk, so I think we'll be using about 100 ml of this, 11 grams of this, and then you just add in your coffee.
I'm not burning my tongue so I can see if it's on camera. No, I'm not doing it.
Furry tongue, furry tongue, furry no. tongue.
I'll sniff it. It sniffs good.
Okay.
The smell of it.
Roxy looks so ladylike over there in the corner. So breakfast is about to go down. Lex has requested some scrambled eggs, so he wants 3 full eggs and some smoked salmon. I am opting for scrambled egg whites. I've got some of the protein cheese, which I like to add into my scrambled eggs, and then some smoked salmon. Then we're going to add in some of these capers, some lemon. I'm going to have mine on a protein thin from Warburtons, and these have really good macros. They're actually less than 15 grams of carbs per thin. And that will be breakfast. I'm also gonna add on some of this lightest Philadelphia on my thin. I am opting for the healthy balance of fats, carbs, and protein, whereas Lex is just going for the protein and the fats in this meal. He's already had some toast, so he is going carb-free for this meal. So here we have my breakfast, my Warburton's protein thins, egg whites, and you can see the capers. I actually put them into the egg whites with the protein cheese and some of the smoked salmon, and I squeezed some of the lemon on top. And then Lex's 3 whole scrambled eggs, some smoked salmon, some capers, and again some lemon to drizzle on top. His and hers. So I'm all cleaned up, ready for the gym. I haven't washed my hair yet. I had what I consider a knacker shower. Put on some deodorant and some dry shampoo in my hair. And I'm gonna have these. It's the Sweet and Salty Nude Popcorn Company. There's 8 grams of carbs, 1.8 grams of fat, a little bit of a pre-workout boost. I have loads of carbs left to eat, but I'm saving them for dinner.
Everybody put them drinks up, put them up. There's some left, you better drink up. Drink it on X. All Oh, you wanna know why? Watch, cause we all gon' bounce. Now the sun gon' down. Don't say money, cause we go all out. Say money. I ain't know I'm gon' flex. Pull it back, back, back it on. We all gon' bounce. Now the sun gon' down. Don't say money, cause we go all out. Yeah, back it on X like a biggie. Big money, more problems, but I still make a milli. Nah, I get a milli out the bank. Yeah. Spend it on the drink, get the shots, go ahead, get tips. Keep it real, roll back the seat. Hold tight when you ride with me. Hold tight. Watch out. Yeah, we might get off the street. Go from left to the right, hit the curb like skirt. Never roll alone. Top down, heads out, bad bitch on the corner star.
Why she over there?
Pour the drinks that don't stop. Make it fucking rain for the girls who don't drop. Drop. Now we might just rage again. Get the shots and the Mary Jane, it's that stage again. Days. Cause we go all night and we just don't sleep. No lifeguard, but we're going in deep. Let me see them hands now, where's my G's? And this shut down, you know me. She know me, I know you, I know we. Cause we all gon' bounce. Now the sun gone down. Don't say money cause we go all out.
What's wrong, Lex?
Everything. It hurts. Everything hurts. It hurts. I wanted to quit after quads.
Sweaty.
And then my bicep. I can't. My arms. It's not going away.
I had to take very long rest periods in between my circuit. Were you impressed with my circuit?
Yeah, it's tough.
I just did four of them. It's called my super extra bonus party day. Because it's my bonus day, so I kind of feel like if I do anything, it's better than nothing. So I've already done my full weekly workout.
Mm. I threw up a couple of times in my lap.
I had a few moments when I was doing that.
Give me a kiss.
I don't know.
Come on.
So we're going to Lidl now to get supplies.
So I am making Lex a post-workout shake. We've got some frozen bananas, some frozen raspberries, some strawberries, blueberries, and a scoop of this protein. And I'm gonna top it up with some of this pip and nut almond with coconut drink.
Just gonna test it for poison, you know. Really good, really fruity. He is currently playing with a bowl because she's a little weirdo. Oh, husband.
Much life.
He's feeling a bit queasy, so he's eating some chocolate rice cakes. And now he has a shake. Taste it.
Oh, that's too delicious.
Yeah?
Boop.
Bailey, can I have your bowl? Can I have your bowl?
Good girl.
Can mammy have it?
Run away, Bailey. Run away. What are you going to get? I'll get it. I'll see you know.
Look at her little tail wagging.
I'll get your
bowl. Roxy really doesn't understand the bowl situation.
No, that's not quite.
I am making myself a low-dough pizza. I'm going to have one of these low-doughs. They taste... I don't know how you describe it. They're super light, so they're not heavy like a pizza dough, but they're very versatile and they give you that fake away pizza. And I'm gonna top it with some of this Eat Lean grated cheese. Get this from Muscle Food. I'm gonna chop up one of these chicken fillets, also from Muscle Food, and I love these. They're just so handy for on the go. And then I'm also gonna add on some of these mild picante peppers because they're delicious and tasty. Last but not least, obviously I have to add on some of this smoky barbecue. So it's going to be like a chicken barbecue pizza. You may have seen it on my Instagram before. And it's super yummy.
Lex is almost through his Everest of a shake. You feeling a bit better now?
Yeah. Not what made me feel so sick before. So it did make me feel sick again. You, yeah. Ran through all the bushes, all on the edge of the garden. But then where did you do your dump? Hmm? Right in the middle of the lawn. Right in the middle, Amy.
Yeah. She likes to display. So here is my low-dough, low-calorie pizza. The base does not take as long as a regular pizza to bake, so just keep an eye on it. I just had it in for like 5 minutes, just until the cheese melted. I also added on some of the red onion because I love the flavour. And I'm going to enjoy this now. Mm. fake pizza. Yummy. So I've had my pizza. I've been just watching, chilling out, watching some Saturday TV, coffee, and haven't had my protein bar today. So I'm having one of these, the chocolate peanut butter ones. I really like these, and they're low in fat. They're only like, I think like less than 4 grams, 5 grams of fat. Perfect. So I have showered. We are going to take the dogs for a walk up to the pub up the road, get a glass of wine and relax because it's a Saturday evening. But I thought first I'd give you a quick physique update. As I said, I'm sitting at about 117 pounds. The lowest weigh-in I had during prep was 108.6 pounds, but I didn't hold that at all, and even for my second competition I was up closer to 110. So I'm only about 7 or 8 pounds up on the scales, which is not too bad for my off season. I'm hoping to hold this weight until I potentially start another prep, and I like maintaining this weight. I think it's quite a comfortable weight for me. Ideally, I think just long term, I'd like to be maybe 1 or 2 pounds lighter than I am now. Even if I was the same weight and just a little bit leaner, I'd be happy. I just feel like the 2 pounds would like drop that little bit that I'd like to see off my body. So without further ado, here is my physique update for my off season. Yeah. Baby girl, you're so damn fine, though. Wanna know if I can hit it from behind, though. I'm sipping on you like some fine wine, though. When it's over, I press rewind, though. Talking bands, I got it. Benjamins in my pocket. I traded in my truth for some Robins, and he's playing Batman. Fatty's gonna rob him. Yeah. I got the Glock in my Robin. 17 shots, no 38. Yeah, I got the Glock in my Robin. 17 shots, no 38. Yeah, she's fine. Wondering will she be mine? Walk past, I press rewind. See that ass one more time. And I got this soda. What's going on, Bailey? You like being in the pub? Are you up to rocks? So we are in from the pub and we didn't get any food, we just had a glass of wine, walked dogs, and then we walked around the block with the dogs. And Lex is having leftovers. I know it doesn't look very appetizing, but it is delicious. It's my leftover chili from last night. The recipe should be up on my recipe channel in the next couple of days. So it's chili topped with some of the Eat Lean protein cheese, and then some of this, I don't know how you pronounce that, kvarg? It's like a quark, but it's like a natural yogurt, and it's really good macros, and I love their actual flavored yogurts as well. So per 100, it's only 3.3 grams carbs and a crazy 12 grams protein, no fat. So it has the same effect as sour cream, and he's gonna have that. He's kind of on a low carb day today, so he's trying out higher fats, and I'm just gonna make him eat this lavash pita bread that I got from Muscle Food as well. Just get something into them. And I have the frying pan already heating up. I have some chicken and I just have some of the Italian herbs and some granulated onion. Then I have some chopped peppers. I literally went for what was in the fridge and needed to be used. I have some red onion, some garlic. I'm going to add in some of this spreadable protein cheese from Eat Lean. I am loving this stuff, guys. I get it from Muscle Food, but you can also pick it up in most supermarkets now. And then I'm going to add in some of this Tilda sun-dried tomato basmati rice that I had in the fridge that needs to be used. Pretty much leftover central. I looked in the fridge, saw what was needing to be cooked, and that's what I'm doing, because you don't have to have a gourmet meal every night. Excuse me, I'm just going into the cupboard to get my fry light spray. You don't have to have a gourmet meal every night to eat your macros. You can just look in the fridge and see what fits it. And that's what I'm doing now. Fitting my macros, hitting them, and I'll have to incorporate a glass of Prosecco in there too. but I enjoyed it.
Here we have dinner. You can see the rice, the chicken. I also added in some frozen leeks because I have discovered them and I've been adding them to everything and they taste delicious.
As you can see, it is very easy to create a delicious, yummy meal from what you have that needs to be used in the fridge. You just throw it all together and hope for the best. It's all about practice, guys, and fitting your macros. Final meal of the day, and I am having one of these bad boys, and they have 17 grams of protein in them and they're really good. I top it with a little bit of this gold fiber syrup from Sucrin and also some of this. It's like a cocoa, kind of like a cereal, and I added on top, also from Sucrin. Actually ordered it by accident, but it's really good. We're just in the middle of watching a movie, so I'm gonna go back and watch my movie. Enjoy my yogurt. That's it. Hope you enjoyed the video. I don't know why I'm whispering. I'm not in a movie theater. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. And make sure to subscribe. And make sure to turn on the notifications so you don't miss any of my future videos. Check you next time. 'Cause if I only had 100 fans, I'd take them all to dinner. Talk about the people that we used to be. If I had 100 fans, I'd buy them all the pair.